Hi guys, Paul from PA Brew News. We are filling up a brew here, so I can show you a little bit of the pour. I got a bigger glass for this, so I can enjoy the goodness in which it flows. Okay, we got it all up in there, all up in that shit. Little beer on the table, that's good. That's what we like. Okay guys, here we are. Work outfit, don't give a fuck. We are enjoying two beers at the same time. And these beers have been brought to me by, you know, the great, the above average, Troll Murica. Average Joe, so that's excellent, thank you. This is High Life from Cigar City. I think they're based out of Florida, but I don't know. This is an India Pale Ale. Cigar City Brewing Company, Tampa, Florida. Yep, CigarCityBrewing.com. This is my first Cigar City ale. I just wanted it. I got two. He sent me two, so I wanted to get a big old glass of it. Hilai means merry game. Is a native to the Basque region of Spain. Basque region is the area right between southern France and northern Spain, and that's where a lot of the gypsy kind of stuff comes from, a lot of different kind of culture. Well, really cool stuff, a lot of mysticism and stuff comes from that area. Tampa was once home to this high-speed game, but sadly, all that remains here is the India Pale Ale that we brew in tribute to the merry game. Pair Hilai India Pale Ale with more Hilai India Pale Ale and a little bit more Hilai India Pale Ale. And because I don't eat and drink at the same time, so I just drink and drink at the same time. So that works out well. No tasting notes, just a little bit of pairing stuff and the backstory. So that's pretty cool. Definitely, if you're a traveling person, definitely go check out the Basque Country, because I hear it's absolutely lovely. Here's a Ellicottville little ad, placemat, whatever the fuck you want to call this thing. I can't remember. Coaster, I think that's what it's called. But sent to me by the great Joe. I had more of them, unfortunately, different ones, but the kids just completely latched onto them, and I don't know where they went. Anyway, enough jibber jabber. Put some of these ales away, and we will continue. Let's get a nose on it. Okay, there's a little bit of, wow, that's kind of weird. Everything's kind of flat across the board. You are getting the pines, you're getting some earthiness, and you're getting some of that. Actually, there's a little bit of floral hop in there too, and the citrus, but everything is, nothing stood out to me. It was just like flat out, that's what it was. And there's a lot of sweetness too. Yeah, there's some zesty notes, a lot of sweetness. There's a lot, it seems like a really big malt base actually. So everything, well, in the nose anyway, I guess. Noses are sometimes deceptive. But that really is a creamy looking head. It's really flat out. Nice haze going. Holy cagazawaga. Particleization going on. I didn't know you should really shake a little bit of crap out of it. There's a lot of particles floating around in here. Let's get a taste on it, see what we think. Cheers. Wow. That is really, really balanced. Yeah, it smelled like there was a good balance, and there is. That's a really big malt bill on this one. And it's really nicely, it's not super sweet, guys. This is not a super sweet ale. I'm just saying it's balanced. The malt bill is balanced with the hop bill. Not super sweet, but very creamy. There's a real nice medium mouthfeel to this one. The only problem is it's not massive in the flavors. To me, it isn't. This is about 6 to 7 weeks old, he said. Well, it's canned, but it should retain a little bit of freshness. The kids are screaming. That's awesome. If you let it sit in your mouth before you swallow it, waft it around, you get a nice earthy bitterness, piney bitterness. finishes with a little bit of zesty notes, a little citrus notes. This isn't bad at all. You know what this is? This is a really, really great sessionable IPA. I don't know what the ABV is, but the way it drinks, you could really slug these back easy. 7.5% alcohol by volume. That was a little hard to read, but I can see where the texts are. Yeah. Not harsh at all. Spoiled to me, there's not harsh. You do get some bitterness, some mild bitterness. Nice flavors. A little bit of sweetness going on. A little bit of the hop character. Really blending well together. Oh, okay. Actually, I was just about to say, nothing really, really standing out. But now, for some reason now, it's just starting to... This kind of piney bitterness is starting to linger around along the tongue, in the cheeks. Getting a little bit more of that IPA quality. Still very sessionable, though. Yeah. Alright, good, good, good. Good, I'm getting more of that kind of quality that I like, that residual bitterness. It's kicking up now. Really, really, maybe it was just a touch too cold. Now that it's out in the elements, I'm holding it. We're moving it around, it's getting a little warmer. Remember, good beer gets better when it warms. Anyway, I'm going to give this one a 9. 9 out of 10. It's really good. And it's really good. It's not Heady Topper. It's not Double Jack. It's not this. It's not this. It's not Double IPA. Hell, I'm saying the wrong kind of style. Anyway, IPA. I don't know what kind of IPA I did give a 10 to. I don't know. Anyway, it's really good, though. It's not mind-blowing, but it's really sessionable. There's a lot of good stuff going on. Get it super fresh. Let me know what it is. I know a lot of people like it. It was fresh to 9 days old, and I like it now. I'm probably running over in time now because I've been babbling, but I'm trying to think of something to compare it to. It's not West Coast. Fuck, I drank too many beers. Anyway, I try to really give you a little bit of a... something to compare it to, but I'm having a little bit of a puff moment. Anyway, it's been Paul from PA Brew News. Cheers.